What happens when a 70-year-old retiree steps into a high-paced company? This man has so much spare time that he decides to join a fashion company led by Jules, a young CEO overwhelmed by her career. At first, Ben seems out of place, but his wisdom and kindness soon prove invaluable. Can this unlikely duo help each other find balance between work, family, and personal happiness? Let's find out together. Please do not forget to subscribe to the channel. This movie is about a 70-year-old retiree, Ben, who's lost his wife and is restless with too much free time on his hands. Searching for purpose, Ben stumbles across an unusual opportunity: a senior citizen internship program at an online clothing retailer called About the Fit. Eager for a new experience, Ben applies with a video CV that impresses the team, leading to an interview where his enthusiasm and desire to keep learning stand out. Despite being told he's overqualified, Ben lands the position. The CEO of About the Fit, Jules Austin, is a strong-driven, young entrepreneur who built the company from scratch in just 18 months. She's constantly juggling meetings, phone calls, and zipping through the office on her bike, leaving little time to connect with her family or enjoy the success she's worked hard to achieve. When Ben is assigned to be Jules's intern, she's less than thrilled. She had completely forgotten about the senior internship program. She feels hesitant and worries that Ben's age and old-school ways will only slow her down. She reluctantly agrees to keep him for at least 6 weeks, unsure how to handle this unconventional situation. On his first day, Ben arrives at the office determined to make a positive impression. He quickly meets fellow interns Doris and Davis, all from different walks of life but united by their passion for fashion. Ben's simple desk setup, a pen, notebook, and watch, stands in stark contrast to the tech-laden workspace of his younger peers. However, despite his initial worries about fitting in, Ben wins over his colleagues with his friendly demeanor and willingness to adapt. He also learned that he had to meet Jules at 3:55 p.m. sharp. Becky, her assistant, warned him that Jules was very busy and had another meeting at 4 p.m. She also told him to talk fast and blink a lot because Jules was annoyed by people who did not. Ben thought that was strange advice, but he decided to follow it anyway. When he met Jules, he was surprised by how young and energetic she was. She greeted him briefly and told him that she did not have much work for him yet. She said he would get an email if something came up. Then she rushed to her next meeting. While waiting for an official task from Jules, Ben throws himself into learning as much as possible about the company and its fast-paced environment. He helps out wherever he can, earning the nickname Mr. Congeniality from Cameron, one of the managers. Ben also becomes a mentor of sorts to the younger employees, offering advice based on his life experience. When one intern, Jason, finds himself in trouble after cheating on his girlfriend, Ben encourages him to apologize face-to-face instead of hiding behind vague text messages. Eventually, Ben's first real task arrives through Jules's assistant, Becky. Jules needs her jacket cleaned after spilling soy sauce on it, but she's still wearing it. Tasked with retrieving the jacket, Ben approaches Jules's office and overhears her discussing the possibility of a new CEO being brought in to help manage the company. The investors want a more seasoned leader, which frustrates Jules, but she reluctantly agrees to consider it. Ben feels for Jules and becomes more determined to be helpful in any way he can. As Ben's presence in the office grows, so does his bond with the staff. He earns praise for his ability to clear clutter from Jules's workspace, a small but meaningful gesture that doesn't go unnoticed. He even finds himself forming a romantic connection with Fiona, the office masseuse. Despite an embarrassing moment when she gives him a short massage. One day, Ben catches Jules's driver drinking on the job. Ben intervenes, insisting the driver inform Jules that he can't work, and offers to take his place. Jules reluctantly agrees, warning Ben that she'll be making confidential calls during the ride. Over the course of the drive, Ben learns more about Jules's personal struggles. She's constantly fielding stressful phone calls, including one from her overbearing mother and another about the ongoing CEO search, which isn't going well. Seeing Jules struggle, Ben buys her a cup of soup, knowing she hasn't eaten all day, and gently suggests that she take better care of herself. At home, Jules's husband Matt and their young daughter Paige greet her. Matt is a stay-at-home dad who supports Jules's career but is quietly disappointed that the CEO search hasn't yielded any result yet. The family dynamic is strained, with Jules often too exhausted from work to fully engage with her family. The next day, Jules's driver is still unavailable, so Ben steps in once again. He observes Jules's hectic morning routine, where she expertly balances work and family life while ignoring judgmental looks from other parents at the school drop-off. Ben also sees how she handles crises at work with calm and efficiency, admiring her leadership skills. As Ben continues to settle into his role, he grows closer to Jules. One evening, they share a pizza in the office while working late. The two begin to open up about their lives. Ben tells Jules about his past job in the same building, back when phone books were still relevant. They laugh together, and Jules helps Ben set up a Facebook account, deepening their connection. Doris arrives the next morning to take Jules back to the office. She had enjoyed the 6 weeks of having Ben as an intern, but now he is gone. He's moved to another section of the company. Doris, who is 72 and can't drive, lets Jules take the wheel as she calls Cameron and begs him to return Ben. She misses his calming influence and his competence. She tracks him down at a coffee shop, where he is getting coffee for his new coworkers. She grabs some cups, apologizes to him, and asks him to come back to her side. Ben's growing influence is not lost on the staff, with Becky in particular, feeling threatened by his expertise. However, Ben reassures her that he's not there to compete but to help. Ben quickly proved his worth to Jules, offering insightful advice and drawing from his vast experience. Jules began to rely on him more and more, which surprised Cameron. Ben also acknowledged Becky's contributions and education, encouraging Jules to recognize her as well. Meanwhile, Davis, who needed to move out of his parents' house, announced his plan to stay with his cousin in Philadelphia. Realizing how difficult the commute would be, Ben invited Davis to live with him, which amazed Davis, especially Ben's impressive house and his collection of handkerchiefs, which Ben insisted were an essential for any gentleman. The following morning, Jules was excited about her upcoming trip to San Francisco for a meeting with a prominent CEO. She asked her husband Matt if he wanted to join her, but he declined, explaining that he needed to stay for Paige's school activities. Although Jules understood, she felt guilty for leaving them. On her way to work, Jules encountered a crisis with a client who was upset and demanding. Feeling overwhelmed, she checked her phone and saw a missed call from her mother. Listening to her mother's voicemail, filled with criticism, Jules snapped. In frustration, she sent an angry email to Matt but accidentally sent it to her mother instead. Panicked, she turned to her workers for help. Ben, along with Jason, Davis, and Lewis, went to her mother's house to delete the email from her laptop before she returned home. After facing several challenges, they succeeded just in time. That evening, Jules treated them to drinks as a thank you. She realized how funny and intelligent they were and ended up enjoying the evening. However, she drank too much and ended up vomiting in a trash can. Meanwhile, Ben and Fiona's relationship blossomed, and their first date at a funeral surprisingly turned out well. The next day, Ben picked up Jules for work and noticed Matt was acting off. He saw Paige upset about going to a party with a sitter, so he offered to take her. While returning home, Ben saw Matt with another woman, which left him feeling angry. Later, he confronted Matt indirectly, asking about how he felt about the new CEO, but Matt avoided the question. Ben returned to work, where Jules and his other colleagues noticed he didn't look well, but he brushed it off. During their flight to San Francisco, Jules sensed something was wrong with Ben. He eventually confessed that, despite his tough exterior, he was a softy at heart. That night, after a fire alarm went off, Jules invited Ben into her room, where she revealed that she had discovered Matt's infidelity. Ben confirmed he had seen Matt with another woman and comforted Jules, assuring her it wasn't her fault. He advised her to hire a CEO only if she truly wanted to and reminded her that she could have both a successful career and a fulfilling marriage. The next day, Jules had an extensive meeting with the CEO. She was impressed by his vision and, without hesitation, offered him the job. Jules believed this decision would benefit both her career and her marriage. She shared the news with Ben, who congratulated her. Later at home, she told Matt about her choice, expecting him to be pleased. However, Matt seemed confused and asked who she meant by us. Jules clarified that she meant their relationship, not her company, and felt a deep sadness as she realized she was sacrificing her dream. That night, she cried in the bathtub, questioning if she had made a mistake. The next morning, Jules went to visit Ben to thank him for his constant support. She was surprised to see Davis and Fiona at Ben's house, looking quite comfortable together. Jules smiled, happy for them, and shared that she still felt confident in her decision. Ben, however, reminded her of her passion for her business and how hard she had worked to build it. He asked her how giving up her company would resolve Matt's affair and suggested that she had come to him because she wanted to be talked out of it. Ben told her he was her best friend and only wanted her to be happy. Back at her office, Jules noticed a bouquet of flowers from the CEO with a note expressing his excitement about working with her. She also received a thank you card from a bridesmaid whose dress Jules had fixed earlier, along with some wedding photos. Feeling proud and joyful, Jules realized how much she loved her company and that she wasn't ready to give it up. She asked Becky to inform the CEO that she had changed her mind. Just as she was about to hang up, Matt entered and told Jules he appreciated her hiring the CEO for his sake, but didn't want her to sacrifice her happiness for him. He admitted to the affair but said it was over, and that he wanted to work on their marriage. Jules revealed that she had known about the affair and was glad it had ended. They embraced and promised to be better partners. At the end of the movie, Jules met Ben, who was doing Tai Chi in the park. He invited her to join, saying it would help her relax. Jules accepted, finding a sense of peace and happiness.